From the banks of the Allegheny, welcome to Film Bits Sicario, Part 8. Oh boy, we're almost done. Second to last part here. When we left off, Kate was in the tunnels, and we were getting ready to cut to a new scene. So let's pick it up at the cut. Another one of the bird's eye views. Those boys are moving fast because they can hear the gunshots.
Dale.
If you analyzed all the times that Villeneuve did that, those bird's eye shots, you might be able to come up with some sort of reasoning. Oh!
Medellin.
Anyway.
Freeze!
Oh, he knows him. Medellin.
Step away from him.
Put that down.
I mean it. Move away from him right now.
Oh! Shot her. He's not messing around.
Don't ever point a weapon at me again. Catch her.
Ooh.
Get back up there.
Now, there's something you don't really think was coming. Alejandro not playing. Put two into her vest, knowing it would mess her up, but that it wouldn't hurt her. So now, we really know why we have our Mexican cop. Love this composition here. The lighting on Silvio's face, just a little bit in shadow. And because of where Alejandro is positioned in the back seat as he leaned over to talk to Silvio, we just get like the top half of his face in the light as well in this all dark interior of the car at night. Good stuff. Pick it back up.
Tengo un hijo.
Goes right to the son because he knows he's in trouble.
Is he through yet?
We have joy.
Love those big shadows on the bluffs due to the headlights of the cars.
The clean fucking hot, my friend.
Except for these two assholes.
I like it better overseas.
You want the babysit?
Where's Kate?
I thought she was with you.
We gotta go back.
Oh, shit. Boys, we're missing one. Let's go.
Oh. Oh man, just lay back, baby. And look at Matt. Matt's not messing around either.
Stop moving. Stop.
Stop it.
I love how Villeneuve, even though the focus obviously here is on Matt and Kate, but if you look in the background, you see those guys and those shadows on those bluffs and hills and stuff, mountains, mesas, whatever the term is. It's almost like surreal to see them all lit up and be behind Matt. It's interesting backdrop. Pick it back up.
Just relax. All right, you gonna stay there? Are you gonna stay there?
All right. You listen. You went up the wrong tunnel. You saw things you shouldn't have seen.
You went up the wrong tunnel. Yep. Alejandro.
It's Medellin.
Medellin refers to a time when one group controlled every aspect of the drug trade, providing a measure of order that we could control. And until somebody finds a way
Look at how serious Matt is now.
20% of the population to stop snorting and smoking that shit. Order's the best we can hope.
He's not Mr. Lighthearted now.
And what you saw up there was Alejandro working toward returning that order.
Alejandro.
Great line.
Alejandro works for anyone who will point him toward the people who made him. Us. Them. Anyone who will turn him loose. So he can get the person that cut off his wife's head and threw his daughter into a vat of acid.
Ooh. Yeah.
That's what we're dealing with.
Yeah.
You can't do this. You can't.
You can, because we have
I'm
you.
Sure as shit, not the person you're gonna hide it all behind.
You need to just take a breath.
You're gonna fucking talk.
No, you're not.
Yeah. I'm gonna tell everyone what you did.
Ooh.
That would be a low angle mistake.
High angle. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Big time pissing contest right there. And now all the secrets are out. Tempers are flaring. We're getting close to the goal. Things are getting ratcheted up.
Is that the target up ahead or confirmed?
Roger that.
And I love the line that Matt used. Alejandro's for hire for anyone that will let him loose against those that made him. That made him. It's a great line. Love the sweat. Love the added touch of the sweat. And now we know, with the title of the film, Sicario, Hitman, who the true hitman is. It's Alejandro.
Muy bien.
Again, love that lighting. Half in shadow, half in dark. Just perfect for who Alejandro is and what is going on here. A little blue light coming in there. It's interesting that Deacons, when lighting this, chose to go with the difference of the blue light in the forward car and the yellowy gold light in the back car, the car that Alejandro is in. Looks like a visual cue just to let you know, and then the darkness, which car is which, if you can't quite make out the forms. Now, of course, this cop is under their employ, which is why the guy who's out of the car said what he said. What a good police officer you make, Silvio. The irony. And now Silvio's exiting the car. And Silvio knows that this is not good for him. Ooh. Oof. So all this time they were talking about Diaz and wanting Diaz to go into Mexico and blah, blah, blah. Now we're finding out the real reason, because this was the plan all along. Get Diaz back so they can have easy access to Diaz's boss. I think here we felt that Diaz was the key. He's not. He's just another tool. And then poor Silvio, the dirty cop, who Alejandro has no pity for. His soccer-playing son, etc. Of course, the irony is that his last act is actually doing police work, telling a guy to get out of his car, etc., even if he's not doing it out of his own accord. Alejandro is a bad man. And that is where we are going to pause that. All right. Next time, the final segment, the finish. Alejandro is at the house of Diaz's boss, who obviously was the one to cut off his wife's head and to throw his daughter into a vat of acid, or at least gave those orders. See you then. Take care.